Hello, my name is Anthony Hall. In this tutorial, we're going to be looking at creating a very basic pair of steampunk glasses. So let's jump in and get started. So I'm going to start with the disc tool, bring up the numerical, and then decide which axis you want it to run by, like so. Let's make it a little bit thinner. And then what I'm going to do is where the in the numerical, what I'm going to do is add some segments. Let's say, let's have a look at this. We can start with 4, see how we get on with maybe. Let's just make sure it's centered, like so. And drop the tool down. So we've got this basic shape of one of our glass, part of the glasses, like so. Okay, so let's make sure on polygons. Select the front and back polygon. We'll go to multiply bevel. We're going to hold control to lock the axis just coming in, like so. And we're going to do it, let's just zoom in a bit. Okay, so let me pull it in a little bit. And then I'm going to right mouse and pull it in again, like so. And then right mouse again, like so. So we've got this thick area, like so. Then I'll jump to smooth shift, and then we're going to pull it in until we get the center bit, like so, which can be the glass. Okay, so if you want, you can move it forward with the move tool. Just jump onto the move and we can move it forward a little bit, like so. And then what we're left with is this, like so. So what we're going to do is, with steampunk glasses, they kind of arch to protect the side of your eye. It's like an eye, so it's like a socket kind of thing. So let's have a go at trying to do that. So let's just switch to points at the bottom. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to select these half of the points here, look. So we've got like this, if you see. Then I'm going to use the move tool. I'm going to hold control, I'm just going to pull it up. And we'll pull it up so far to about there, like that, okay? So what I want to do is I want to make an arch coming around here. So, I mean, it's kind of a crude way of doing it, but we'll see how we get on. So let's drop the selections, and then I'm right mouse clicking and using the move tool to just move each of these segments to kind of slowly move the actual parts of it, so you're getting this kind of overall shape, like so. And if we keep doing that, so let's select some of these here again, moving forward a bit. I just forgot one there. Let's take that one as well. Just move it up a little bit. So yeah, it does look a bit crude, but hopefully you get the gist of it, how it goes out and around, like so. And again, I think it's a matter of you just deciding yourself how you want it to go. So if I just drop the selection, like so, if I press the tab key on the keyboard, just for the time being, you'll get the gist of the actual look more. Let's just jump back. And what we could do is, down here on the opposite side, is let's select some, let's select these points. And again, with the move, we could just move very slightly these up. So we're kind of making a bit of a more oval bit this side as well. And again, and I can't say I've ever made any steampunk glasses before. I just saw a pair on the internet, and I thought, oh, how hard would it be to make that? So I'm I am kind of making it up as I go on a little bit, but if you've never made something before, that's usually how it goes. Okay, so we've got this here, like so. So other stuff we can do to give it a bit of is let's select, say, this row of polys here, look, and then let's loop them. And then what I'm going to use is use the, let's go to multiply, let's go on multi-shift, bring the numerical up, make sure grouping's on, and let's just pull them out a little bit while bringing it in, so it's up and down with the mouse, and then a right mouse clicking to get a second row, like so. So you've got that, and then let's just tab it again. That's quite nice. Untab. And if you're wondering why you're getting this little error message, it's because that front polygon's just, it's an n-gon, so it's more than, it's got more than 3 or 4 points to it. So, but don't worry about that. So, looking quite nice. So, what we've got currently is a kind of basic shape of what our actual front lens, one of the glasses, is going to be. And again, like I said, I'm just jumping between the subpatch mode. Now, if you wanted to, you could select a couple of polygons here, because what I want to do is maybe add maybe 2 more rows of polygons, loopable polygons, that is. So I like to try and keep my models very loopable, so everything's nice and looks, it's a nice, basically, structured model. So I'm selecting these 2 polygons. I'm going to go to the multiply tab, bandsaw, bring up numerical. So currently I'm on the default, so let's reactivate that, reset it, reactivate, and let's just add from the operations a second line, and let's just tell them to be mirrored, so we've got a lot more polys, making it a lot more structured for me to play around with. Okay, if you want to delete one, in fact, maybe we'll delete one of these, like so. And what you can do while you're on one, if you go to edit, you can decide where the actual curves of the lines and the polys go. So let's add another one, and again let's add this one a bit closer, like so. So we've got that kind of nice part in the middle. Maybe I use this as a bit of a handle part. So let's say I'm happy with that. Okay, so far here's my actual goggle bit that we go to add it and stuff. So on to the next bit. Now with this, let's just select. So what I'm doing is I'm selecting the first 2 polys of this last row here towards the end on the back of the actual goggle. I'm going to loop it, and then I'm going to use a multi-shift again just to bring it out and in, let's say twice maybe, so there's 2 little rows, because usually with these steampunk glands you get like a ridge, like a socket ridge here around the sides, like so. Okay, so I've done that twice with the multi-shift, and I've right mouse clicked it, so I've got this kind of nice little ridge around it as well now, like so. Okay, so I think next what we'll do is, what we need to do is, we could do with making some kind of maybe part here where maybe the glasses bit that goes around your ears, or maybe a strap could come off of it. So if we say, maybe let's go with this one, we'll stick with smooth shift, we'll bring it out a little bit like so, and then I'm going to right mouse click and bring another one out, and then right mouse click and bring another level out, and right mouse click again and bring another level out. So you're kind of getting that, which is way too wide. So what we're going to do is bring up the numerical, and there's these current shifts here, so let's jump back through the shifts, look. So when I do this, it will let you go through the shifts. So then what you can do is you can manipulate them to how you want. Let's do the next one, shift 2, bring it right in, and then shift 3 again, let's bring that in. So you've got this section like this, look, which we can attach something to. So that's manipulating each shift. So you know how I've extruded it on each one. What all I'm doing is go is what this tool lets you do is go back to each part and highlight which part you want to kind of manipulate, and then come in here and manipulate it and stuff. So it's quite cool. But again, you play around. I mean, I've got no design in front of me, so I am making this up as I go along, really. I should really get some reference images. So let's say I was happy with that. Some other stuff you could do is I've seen a couple of steampunk kind of glasses with like decorations on and stuff and spikes. It's had a couple of spikes. So if we go for that one there, and then we'll miss, how many we've missed? I missed two. So and then that one and that one. And then let's go to the multiply, then under more for extended, and let's go down to spiky tool and click, and let's bring up a couple of little spikes like so. Make it look a bit more funky. So that's using the spiky tool to bring up the actual bit that we need, which is quite nice. Okay, so next bit is, if I was happy with this, I'd want two of them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the move tool. I'm going to move it to the side using the black line here as a guide, and let's say half a square based on how you zoomed in. This is on 200mm, because what I'm going to do, I'm not going to remodel this whole thing, I'm just going to mirror it. So if you go to mirror and bring up your numerical, what this does is automatically mirror your glasses. Basically copies this, flips it and puts it the other side, so you're mirroring it exactly across, like cool, like this, which I'm happy with. Just leave using the default, which is nice. They're both on the same layer as well. So now let's have a look at the next bit of how we can join these up. So what I'm going to do is with the polygon tool, I'm going to select these two polygons, and then I'm going to select the two facing like so. Yep. And then under multiply, this is in Lightwave 2020. So under more, there's a spleen bridge. So if you click that, what it does, it puts this little bridge in. It's probably going to have none for division. So what you need to do is put a few divisions in it. So let's put a few in. You get between each division, you get these little points that you can manipulate. Look. So what you could do is just simply come in here and let's move these up, these little points, making a little arch. And you get the little handles look as well, which is pretty cool. I can grab them. So I'm basically making a little arch for the nose to go on, like so. And then we've got that little join there for our glasses, like so, which is quite cool. So we've actually got, now we've got our actual main shape. So we can either have some, like some kind of strap, which if I'm going to use that, I'm going to use PX Bezier, the PX Bezier tool, which is a free plugin, which I'll put in the description. Yeah. I've installed it, but obviously it's in my additional, so PX Bezier. Okay, so when it comes up, we're going to, instead of a polygon line, we're going to use a belt. And what you need to do is, maybe in your right view, is start to draw out the actual belt. Now, it's currently on the wrong angle, so we need to rotate the bank part, let's say by 90%. So what we get is this. Also, what you can do is, let's just move it over here So we're actually doing it in line with where the actual part where I want it to be attached to is. So if we have a look, like so. Also, the radius, based on how what size you've made yours, you need to play with the radius, decide how thick the strap is, like so. And then you can carry on coming round. And again, I'm going to do this quite quickly because you get the gist of it. So I've got this kind of strap. And if you wanted to, if you want to model it, you can pull it down at the side so it's like on the floor and stuff, but I'm not going to, I'm just going to leave it like this for you to, so you understand. So I've kind of got this strap using the PX Bezier tool. While it's selected, let's thicken it a little bit. You don't want to do it too much. And then you can press sub patch if you want to smooth it, like so. So we've kind of got our glasses with the actual band at the back holding it to the actual glass. So, I mean, at this stage, then you've got it. We've got to kind of work out how it would be attached. I mean, you could just move the polys and make it so it's just attached to this bit here if you want. I mean, you could also, you could maybe bring this out a bit on each side and maybe make it look like it's attached in some way. Again, that's up to you. So, I mean, as you can see, it's not quite on there. But again, if I was going to move him, I would just literally come in my top view like here and make sure I'm on points, and then maybe manipulate and move the points so the more on the part, like so. So again, the opposite side as well. Let's have a look. Not quite there, is it? So we can move it, rotate it, and then place it where we kind of want it to be. And yeah, so that's it. Very basic pair of steampunk glasses. And then obviously you just left to kind of texture it, and yeah, off and going. I mean, I've tried to use the bare minimum tools I can just to show you how easy it is to do. And I'm sure when you're making it as well, you can add even more detail and stuff. But the good thing about it, everything's kind of loopable, and it's kind of a clean mesh to work with without, you know what I mean? Because I've downloaded free stuff here and there to use models, and they're a mess. It's like somebody's drunk and when they modelled it or something. So, again, hopefully you enjoy this tutorial. Thanks for listening. Please share, subscribe, check out my other tutorials, and head over to the Lightwave Salvation Facebook group, because there's loads more cool stuff on there as well. See you next time.